This is MissVindicat. Yes, that's right. I've returned to make another video. So hello, how have you all been? Please let me know in the comments, I'd love to hear. At least that is if you want to tell me, because I know I've been missing like months. And actually, it is because of DanishVlog that I've returned. As you guys know, she was one of the whispers that I first came across, and I really liked her, and she was also one of the reasons that I started making videos myself, and we've been friends like, I don't know, way, you know, like years ago. And she also kind of stopped making these videos, and this week she made another one, and she talked about how the community changed and about what she doesn't like about it. And I don't know, I just got all nostalgic, and I just, I don't know, it kind of hit home with me. I agree with her on a couple of things she said, like I already pointed out in a comment below her video. But also, it kind of struck me that I really missed making videos. And I guess, as some of you know, if you've listened to my last video that I made, I think it was back in January or something, I'm not quite sure. Already I was kind of not having that much fun anymore by making these videos. Mostly because I felt pressured, because there were so many whispers out there, and there were all these role plays and ASMR things, and I just got overwhelmed, and it felt like nobody really needed me. And also I felt pressure because I wanted to react to all the comments, and it just was, you know, it got impossible to do. So it just felt like a chore to me. And I don't know, somehow by listening to this video of DanishVlog, I just thought like, oh damn, I missed making videos. And I thought like, well, even, you know, somehow I kind of missed the old community that we got, which was like intimate and private and small, and now it seems to be also big. But at the same time, I was like, I don't want to make videos anymore, because I feel like I've become, how do you say, redundant. There are so many out there. But then I thought, hey, actually I should be making videos, because first of all, well, I'm in the mood to do so again, but secondly, if not all that many people are going to listen to me, because there are all these amazing role plays, and I don't know what it is, you know, because there's so much right now, then that's a good thing, because then I can have this intimate community again. And I just started listening to like all the old favorites of me, like Louise 31 and Decaying Whisper and The Whispering Voice and Snarky Whispers, and I don't know, many others as well. Soothing Whisper, Soothing Whispers back too. He also made a video on The Whispering Night, and I don't know, and it just felt like, yes, I'm just gonna start again. And I don't know, you know, if like DanishVlog is going to stay this time, and what, I don't know, it would be so great if all the old school ones, we, you know, return, and just, we can still listen to each other's videos and comments, and have this community within the bigger whispering community, you know, like the old school ones. Well, anyhow, don't feel pressured, because I totally understand that people don't like to make whisper videos anymore. I mean, I've been away for months now. So anyway, enough of the bullshit about whispering and the community. I've got this magazine for you guys. And since that comes with a newspaper. And this is from the Dutch newspaper NRC Handelsblad, and it is from May actually already. But it's like a theme thing, and it's all about LA. And I've been to LA in March and April with a friend of mine, and we had such a great time. And I didn't even make a whisper video about it, which feels like totally strange because I used to, you know, vlog about all my trips. So you've missed one. Maybe I can make one, you know, with the pictures. Just let me know if you would want to see it. Well, anyway, let's see. So here it is, and I just started reading it today, even though I had it like for a while. A colleague gave it to me, and I didn't even realize it was about LA, even though, you know, like, obvious. Well, never mind. It is about Leon de Winter and Jessica Duurlacher, and they are two writers from the Netherlands, and they're like a couple, you know. I don't know if they're married, but they're together, and they have two children. And, well, yeah, I have like red nails. Great, right? I'm in love with red nails at the moment. Well, anyway, they've lived in LA for, I don't know, several years, and right now they live in Holland again for like a couple of months, and he wants to go back and she doesn't. And this magazine is all about LA and their favorite places, and about why they want to return or don't want to return, and it's just really nice, I think. So I'm going to show it to you. I'm going to try to be quiet. So we've got a couple of advertisements, which is great because, you know, that kind of reminds me of the old magazine videos that I used to make. Here we've got this Chanel magazine ad, and yeah, I like it. Yeah, I like the red lips, and I also like the black nails, even though I would never do black nails. I don't know, it's kind of, it feels like it's just for 16-year-olds, but it does look good on her. So here we've got some more clothes. Let's see, I think this is kind of plain. Yeah, it's a bit boring. And itself and screen. And this story tells that it's like that this screen is like everything else in LA, which is totally fake, because there's like a parking lot behind here, and this green is just like a very small piece of green on a fence. Yeah, I don't know why I'm telling this. Here we've got the couple itself. I think they look great. She especially, she's almost 50 years old, but she looks young, and not in a bad way, you know, not like in a bimbo way. Is bimbo even an English word? Just tell me, do you know what bimbo is? I don't know. Well, anyway, here's like the big interview. With the second part. And pictures from Hollywood and their family and, I don't know, things in LA. And here we've got Angelina Jolie. Say hi or